All right, now it's time to talk about hyperparameter tuning. We will go into why there is a problem with neural networks, like why do we have to talk about it even, and then I will tell you some of the common ways of doing hyperparameter tuning and also give you some ideas on what kind of libraries that you can use. So let's get started. Let's say we have two hyperparameters, right? Let's say we are trying to optimize the number of neurons per hidden layer for one layer. That is because you can have different number of neurons in each layer, in each hidden layer, and the optimizer. So let's say we are trying gradient descent, RMS prop, momentum, and atom. What's going to happen is that in this case, we have 20 cases, and that wouldn't even be very hard to try them, right? We can just try them one by one. But if you also want to add learning rate into this, what's going to happen is all of a sudden you're going to have 60 different possibilities. Because for every combination of optimizer and number of neurons on this hidden layer, you're going to have a different learning rate. So in total, you're going to have 60 different cases that you need to try, 60 different settings. Let's say you also want to optimize for batch size. So if you try three different batch sizes, let's say 32, 64, 128, all of a sudden you have 180 different settings that you need to try on to understand which one works better. And as you can imagine, this can get really big, really fast, because right now we're only optimizing 1, 2, 3, 4 different hyperparameters. And we are trying 4 to 5 or even 3 for some of them, options for each of them. Whereas what could happen in a normal hyperparameter tuning problem is that we are trying to optimize 5, 6, maybe 10 different hyperparameters. And we are also trying out maybe tens of different values for all of these different hyperparameters. So that can get quite big very fast. And that's why we need some smart solutions when we're doing hyperparameter tuning, when we are searching for the best hyperparameter setting for our network. So let's look into some of the approaches that people use for this. The first option is to use grid search. It is one of the very commonly used approaches when it comes to machine learning techniques, but it is very slow because what it does is just tells us to try every single option that is in our hyperparameter space. And when we're building neural networks, this will take a very long time because, as we just talked about, we have a lot of different combination of settings. That's why there is a bit of a different approach to grid search that we use more commonly, and that is random search. What random search does is basically choose some random settings in your hyperparameter space and try them out. You can say, out of the 20 options that I have here, I want to try 5. And then it tries out these 5. And even though this sounds quite simple, random search is used very, very often. And most likely for your personal projects or your side projects, random search is going to be the one that you need out of all of the other hyperparameter tuning techniques that are out there. So as I said, random search works really well for many problems, but there is one thing that you need to consider, and that is the range or the scale that you set for your hyperparameters. So if you're just setting number of neurons in a hidden layer, you can just use normal distribution between 100 and 800. So that could be just your range, and the scale could be a normal scale. But if you are trying to also optimize for learning rate, you shouldn't use normal scale, because what's going to happen is this scale goes from 0.0001. So basically, this is going to be seen as 1. And while you're going at it, you're going to choose learning rates that are bigger than 0.2, bigger than 0.5, etc., etc., all the way until 1. But the learning rates that are going to make the biggest difference for you and the ones that you're interested in are all in this region. So when you are choosing them based on a normal distribution, you're going to choose the ones that are not going to make the biggest difference, because choosing one that is on 0.7 and 1 are not going to be that different. Whereas what you can do instead of this is just use a logarithmic scale. So then when you are choosing your random values on a normal distribution, you will be able to choose the ones that are more relevant to what you're trying to achieve. So always keep in mind the range and the scale that you're setting while you're doing random search. But random search is not perfect, of course. There are some shortcomings. So if you just do random search once, you might not be able to find a really optimal value for your hyperparameters. So what people do is do manual zooming in. So let's see what that is. I'm again giving the example of trying to optimize only for two hyperparameters, the optimizer and the number of neurons per hidden layer. So if we think about it on a three-dimensional sense, we can see actually that there is some sort of an area, and as we can see here, the ones that with the darker orange are going to be higher cost, and the lighter the orange, the lower the cost is going to be. And basically, we're going to have some sort of relationship between the values that our hyperparameters take and the cost, right? Or the error, however you want to call it. So what we want to do with zooming in is we first, again, do a random search, and then we try out some of the values. And based on these values, we look at the ones that are the most promising, that give us the lowest errors. And then we say, I'm going to zoom in in that area and then do another random search. And then we zoom in. As you said, the values here are changing because we are zooming in between 300 and 500 now. And we are getting closer. So of course, we're basically getting closer to that low error area. And also, we also decided only to try RMS prop and momentum. And then you do another random search, and then you get the ones that are really promising to you. So of course, this is a very simple example. Maybe we're able to find it with two or three tries. Normally, what you do is just iterate this and zoom in, find the best values, zoom in more, find the best values there, and zoom in more. But this is a very manual and time-taking process, because what you need to do is you need to run random search, check out the results, decide on the new ranges, run random search again. But instead, you can use a little bit more of sophisticated approaches.